Hi everyone, hope you're doing good today. It's a little bit gloomy outside, but hopefully you're not feeling too blue yourselves. I think it's supposed to brighten up a bit tomorrow, Tuesday, which is actually probably when you're going to open this video, if you're going to complete it, because I'm going to put it up Monday night. So hopefully it all brightens up a little bit tomorrow. So we're going to, as I said yesterday, we're going to try and do some music-based starters this week. Now yesterday, of course, I had my content removed. I was a very naughty boy because I put something on without checking the copyright. So hopefully that won't happen today. So you're going to listen to a piece of music today, and I'd like you to divide your page up into three columns. One that says prime numbers, one that says cube numbers, and one that says square numbers. And I'm going to play a piece of music, and on the screen some numbers are going to pop up, and you've got to put the numbers which go in the correct columns. There's some numbers that don't fall into any of those categories, so you can just leave them to the side and not worry about putting them in at all. But it's going to get faster. As the music gets faster, the numbers are going to come up quicker, so you've got to be super sharp. So if you don't know your primes, your squares, or your cube numbers, I suggest you take 10 minutes to go away, Google them, learn them quickly before you start. You're not allowed to have them there as you go to check on. We won't have time, and also that would be cheating because you've got to know them. So hopefully if you have a look and refresh your memory. If you're not too sure on any of them, maybe you might just want to focus on just doing prime numbers today and just have a column of prime numbers. And when you see a prime number, just write it down. Well, I hope that makes sense. So have your pencil and paper ready. And yeah, let's get on with it. Okay, so I'm going to reveal the answers now. So here we go then. A couple of things you may have noticed is, first of all, that 64 is both a square and a cube number. Can you think of another number that's both a square and cube number? Hopefully you're thinking of the number 1. because 1 × 1 × 1 = 1 and 1 × 1 = 1. One, of course, is not a prime number because the definition of a prime number is it can only be divided by itself and 1, and of course 1 is itself. Okay, so we're going to crank it up with a bit of arithmetic today. So you are going to be using the bus stop method to divide and leaving your answers as a remainder, decimal and a fraction. And you're also going to be using the bus stop method to divide by 2-digit numbers. And of course, there is the best in the business bonus questions to finish. Okay, so we're going to start off nice and straightforward. So this is the bus stop method. Hopefully everyone is familiar with it. So the first thing you have to be able to do is to be able to divide and find a remainder. If you can't do that, then you'll need to learn that skill first of all. I'm not going to go over that now because it will take a long time to go over every little bit. But let's have a look at the first one. So you see how many times 4 goes into 5. So 4 goes into 5 once and you have 1 left over and you put your little 1 there. 4 goes into 12, 3 times, 2 times 4 is 12, with none left over, and then 4 goes into 8, twice. So that's a very straightforward bus stop method. You have to excuse my writing, it's quite difficult to use the laptop with the camera in front of me as well, so hopefully you can make up my numbers. So, then it gets a bit trickier when it doesn't fit in exactly. So, let's have a look at this one, 634 divided by 4. So, 4 goes into 6 once with 2 left over. 4 goes into 23 5 times with, so 4, 5 to 20 with 3 left over. And 4 goes into 34 8 times. 8 fours are 32. And you would have remainder 2 left over. So that's how you would do it as a remainder. If you were going to do it as a fraction, it would just be 158, and that 2 just works as the numerator, and you put the 4 as the denominator. So it'd be 158 and 2/4. I'm just going to rub out my little. Are there? So it's 158 2/4, where you've hopefully worked out that's the same as 158 1/2. So that's how you do it as a fraction. And to do it as a decimal, I can just get the pen up. I'm just going to extend this along a little bit here and put a 0 and a decimal point. And I'm going to put a decimal point here. So I had 2 left over, didn't I? So my 2 left over, which is my remainder, would go there. So I do how many times does 4 go into 20? Which you should know is 5 times. So it's 158.5. And I know I'm right, because I know 0.5 or 0.5 is the same as 1/2. So I could have 158 remainder 2, 158 2/4, or simplified 1/2, or 158.5. Okay, so let's have a look at dividing by 2-digit numbers. So a skill you will need to have when dividing by 2-digit numbers is being able to estimate. And a good way to estimate is by rounding and then doing a quick multiplication in your head. So let's have a look at this first one. 5,405 divided by 23. So the first thing I'm going to do is see how many times 23 goes into 5, which is obviously 0 because 23 is a much bigger number. Now you can write a little 5 there if you want, but as I said before, I don't usually bother with that. So now we need to do how many times does 23 go into 54. So I'm going to round, okay? 23 is close to 20 and 54 is close to 50. So if I was to count up in 20s, 20, 40, 60, I think it's going to be twice, because I think 3 lots of 23 is going to be way over 54. So my first estimate is going to be twice. So I'm going to do a very quick multiplication. You may be able to just double 23 in your head quickly. If not, do a quick multiplication. And I know that 23 times 2, if I was to do a quick column multiplication, is 3 times 2 is 6, and 2 times 2 is 4, so it's 46. So I know it goes in 2 times. And now I need to work out what's left over from 46 to 54. If you struggle to do that mentally and do a quick column subtraction, I can do that mentally. So if I count on 46 to 54, I know that there's 8 left over. So I'm going to do another quick estimate in my head. How many times does 23 go into 80? Well, if I rounded 23 to the nearest 10, I know it makes 20. And if I counted up 20, 40, 60, 80, it goes in 4 times. However, I know that I've rounded that down and it only just fits in exactly 4 times. So I think if I was to do it 4 times, I'm going to go over. So I'm going to go for 3 times. So let's have a look at this. 23 times 3. So 3 times 3 is 9. And 2 times 3 is 6. 69. Again, if you to work out your remainder, how much more you have to count on from 69 to 80, you can do it in your head or you can do it mentally. I am going to do it mentally. Let's have a look at this last one. So I've worked out that there's 11 left over. So 23 into 115. Well, I know that if I rounded it to 20, 115 to 120, it would go in 6 times, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120. However, I've rounded that one up and that one down. So I'm going to go for 5 as my estimate. So let's give it, let's do 23 times 5. 5 times 3 is 15. So 5, carry the 1. 2 times 5 is 10. Add the 1 is 11. Cross that one out so I know I've added it. And I can see it goes in exactly 5 times. Okay, so I'm going to go through this one a little bit quicker. So how many times does 21 go into 6? It goes in 0 times. 28 into 64, my estimate is going to be twice. So you might be able to double 28 in your head. If not, do a quick column multiplication. 28 times 2, well, 8 times 2 is 16. Carry the 1. 2 times 2 is 4, add the 1 is 5 to make 56. Cross my little 1 out. So it goes in twice. From 56 to 64, I have got 8 left over. My next estimate is 28 into 87. So I know 2 lots of 28 make 56. I'm going to go for an estimate of 3 times. Let's see what 3 gets. 28 times 3. So 8 times 3 is 24, 4, carry the 2, 2 times 3 is 6, add the 2 is 84. So it goes in, yep, definitely if I added another 28, I'm going to go over 87, goes in 3 times with 3 left over. Okay, 28 into 35. Pretty straightforward, that one. It's got to go once, hasn't it? And my remainder would be 3. No, it wouldn't. It'd be 7. My apologies. So you could have 231 remainder 7, or you could have 231 and 7 28ths. But I'm going to do it as a decimal. You might have already worked out 7/28 is the same as a quarter. If you have, what do you think the decimal is going to be? So we've got our 7 left over. How many times is 28 going to 70? Now, if you have a look earlier on, these are useful now, aren't they? Because I can check back. I know that times 3 is too many, so, and I know that 28 times 2 is 56. So it's going to be 2 with 14 left over. 28 into 140. My estimate is going to be 0.25 because I think it's going to be 0.25 because I think it's a quarter. Have to bear with me. I'm a bit slow on using this keyboard. Here we go then. So 8 times 5 is 40. Okay, the 4. And 2 times 5 is 10. Add the 4. Makes 100. And 40, I was right. So, $6,475 divided by 28 is 231.25. Okay, so here's some for you to have a go at on your own. Can you leave your answer as a remainder fraction decimal if they don't divide in exactly? So some of them fit in exactly and there won't be anything left over. But if there is, I would like you to answer it as a remainder, as a fraction, and as a decimal. Okay guys, so here's the answers. A couple of things you might have done. If you just look for number 3, you could have simplified the 3/15 to a fifth. The number 5, you could have simplified the 18/24 to 3/4. And number 6, you could have also simplified the 8/32 to 1/4. So if you want to mark your work now, press pause. And then we'll get on to the next bit. So here's your best in the business bonus questions if you want to press pause and have a stab at these. So here's the answers. I'm just going to talk you through how I would have worked these ones out. So 6.9 times something equals 855.6. So therefore, 855.6 divided by something equals 6.9, or 855.6 divided by 6.9 equals something. So I would have just made 855.6, I would have made that 10 times bigger, and I would have made 6.9 10 times bigger. So I would have done 8,556 divided by 69, and hopefully you should have worked out that the answer is 124. Number 2, 55.25 divided by 17 equals 3.25. Two decimals, each less than one that multiply together to make 0.2. Well, I know 4 times 5 equals 20, therefore 0.4 times 0.5 is 0.2. Because both those numbers are less than 1, when you multiply them together, they're going to get smaller if you think about it. And the last one, I'm just going to give you the answer. It was a 5 and then a 4 at the bottom. Okay, so I hope everyone got on with everything okay today. Thanks to all those people that have liked and commented and subscribed. I do really, really appreciate it. And please feel free to share these videos with anyone you think they may be of use to. Apart from that, stay safe, be good for your mum and dad, and I'll catch you tomorrow.